It's a really interesting thing. The ego is part of the Maya. Everyone's ego is part of that collective consciousness because that's where all the thoughts were formed. So everything that you have ever thought is part of this world. It's not unique to you. So when we say there's a negative thought that comes up out of the blue, it's not your thought. Your thought, your higher self, we're talking about the higher self thought, is a wisdom thought, or it's a loving guidance to do something. I'm not just talking about your everyday, you know, because you still need the mind that has been taught how to drive a car or a truck for Jean Ann, or to make a cup of tea or to cook, all those memories and all those sort of things. Yeah, they're required and we want to keep them so that we know how to function in this world. But I'm not talking about the functionality of the mind, what we've been taught at school. I'm talking about the other side, which works with the ego. So if you have a negative thought all of a sudden about somebody else, for example, out of the blue, and you feel compelled to say something to this person, or just, it might be a family member or something, that's not you. The Maya, the ego, that huge thing, thinks it's alive, thinks it's real, thinks it has power. It doesn't really think per se. It's more random, like rabbit holes everywhere. And it will come up with any, it knows what you fear because you are part of it. So of course it's going to know you. Like they say, you know, God knows every hair on your head. Yeah, the ego knows every thought because it is part of you. The Maya is part of you. It's not a separate entity that you get pissed off with. So when we do mindfulness, we are saying, okay, this is not my thought. So mindfulness is releasing the thought that you know is not your thought. When you have a feeling of a great requirement within your heart to give, to do something lovely for someone, you don't need anyone else to know you've done it, and you're guided to do that particular thing, and it may not have any emotion in it. It's just a heart thing. Well, that is your thought. That's your divine thought guiding you. Or when you all of a sudden you've got this idea to do a new project or a new type of work, something that's fulfilling, or you start feeling like you really want to start working out and looking after yourself, or you just, I really want to send people light. I want to know how to do that more. You know, these things that are unselfish and compassionate, that we don't care if other people know that we've done it or not. We just, that's us. Whenever we want to improve our life or improve someone else's life, that is your thought. Every time, you know, so eventually as you become more and more mindful that all negative thought, you don't go down a rabbit hole and say, why did I think that thought? Oh my God, I don't want to be like that. I don't want to be nasty. Oh, I don't want to be complaining about stuff. Every time you stop yourself from complaining, or you stop that fearful thought of, I'll be homeless. I don't know what I'm going to do. Whenever you have lack or limiting thoughts, it's not putting icing on an unbaked cake. You stop and you say, okay, let's really look at this. What can I do to shift this situation? You take action on that situation so that you can improve your life. You meditate on it. You know, whenever I've done prayers for you guys and you've sent me your prayers, I've loved doing that, so to release that fear, because when I do it, it's like a reworking of your divine presence, releasing some of those fears that are over that diamond, those little blobs that are over your beautiful diamond, which is your true higher self, which is in that ocean of light. Diamonds, 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 clear consciousness, know thyself. Thyself is clear consciousness. It is immortal consciousness. So don't allow yourself to go down a rabbit hole and say, oh my God, why did I think that thought? You didn't think the thought. So don't put any energy into it. Say, okay, well, that's not my thought. That's not my thought. I would do this minute by minute. Sometimes I would do it 2 days a week. I would just focus on no thought. Any thought that came in, that's not my thought. It's not my thought. In my mind, it's not my thought. Just to get myself into silence of the mind. How do you have silence in your mind? You have to release the thoughts. So that is a really, really great way of doing it. I am one with all of this, but I am not that thought. I am this. I am the tree. I am you. You are me. I am that. So hum. And then shh. Feel it.